Greetings, Marsh here, and welcome to episode 96 of my modded Factorio playthrough. In this episode, we are going to work on building our acid train station and rebuild nitric acid so we can get back to rubite mining. Enjoy! Okay, now that the electrolyzers are done, we can start working on the acids. We have a couple choices here about which ones to start with. Sulfur should probably wait till last since it's the biggest. And hydrofluoric should be nearby since it's going to produce some sulfur byproducts. So we should probably do nitric and hydrochloric, both of which are pretty straightforward. But where do we want to put them? Well, one thing we need to keep in mind is that we need to transport these fluids all over the place. Now, if it's going to the base here, that's easy enough just to send a pipe somewhere if we need to, but what if it's a mining acid that needs to go for this infinite mining, like sulfuric acid here? Now, that's definitely better serviced by a train. So we need to have room in here for a train to come in and be able to pick up acids. I mean, the station can be anywhere. I was thinking, well, we could put it right here, but on the other hand, there is a train track right here we can use, and there's kind of an empty spot right here. Although, it might make sense to do all the crystallizing right there, where we've got slurry here, and right here as well. And this area up here needs to be clear. We could also just keep expanding down here, but in case we ever need more oxygen, it makes sense to leave this open just so this line can go straight down. So we've got options, and I'm not too worried about blocking this bus here because this isn't going to be the bus to end all buses. It's just a central place for all the resources to go. So if it gets too crowded, it can just be moved somewhere else. And, you know, as the factory expands, it's going to transform a few times. So that is what it is. So this is probably as good a place as any. But we probably want to make sure that there's enough room for the train station first. So let's get that built. And it's going to be built in kind of a weird way, because we're going to want to use LTN for this. I don't think we've researched it quite yet. Not yet. So it's pretty simple research, and it unlocks the LTN train station. And also a special LTN combinator. So we'll definitely want those. And I'll put that in there first. I forget the name of that mod. Let me make sure. Yeah, it's called the LTN Combinator Modernized. And that's what that second combinator is for. And I'll show you what it does later if you're unfamiliar with how LTN works. But the general idea of LTN, or Logistic Train Network, is that instead of a train having a set schedule, so in other words, with any other train we have, they have schedules right now, where for Bobmodium, this train is, it parks, and then when it's unloaded of its Bobmodium, it leaves and goes to the Bobmodium patch, which is right here, and then stays until it's loaded, and then goes back. It's very constant. Static. You tell it what you want it to do, and then it keeps doing it. Well, what LTN does is it allows the trains to get dynamic schedules based on what the base needs at the time. So it means that any given train doesn't necessarily have the same schedule. So you have to look at the logistics of acids. So let's say we've got our acids. And in this case, we're going to have four acids on this train. Sulfuric, nitric, fluoric, and chloric. And those are going to be needed for different mines. So we have to send those acids to six different mines. So we have a couple of options here. One is we can have six different trains that are responsible for each mine. So basically, there would be, for sulfuric acid, a train stop here and a train parked, unloading acid. And then when the train got empty, it would leave and go back to wherever it needed to go to pick up the fresh acid. So let's say right here, gets loaded with the acid, then it goes back there and parks, and we'd need one of those for every single patch. So we'd have to have six trains. And that's kind of nuts considering that one train can do all of that easily. Like, acid mining doesn't really require that much acid, so it's kind of a waste. So on the other hand, you could have a train that parks here at the original spot, and then it has all the acids, and it stops at each patch. And it goes maybe bomonium, then it goes to rubite, then it goes up here to jivolite, goes up here to steratite, and makes the rounds. And you could do that, but it's kind of a waste because you're making stops before you need to make stops. Like, it's most efficient for the train to unload its full capacity at a stop, not partial. Plus, that train's going to be constantly making circles unless you have a pretty complicated circuit network. Like, the best you can do for that is to have a circuit network where the train is parked at the loading spot, and then when one of the stops runs low on acid, it sends a logistic signal back to the train stop that'll start the train on its route, but it'll still go to each stop and top everything off, and that's technically fine. It'll work, but when you think of long-term and the efficiency of trains, it's kind of a waste because that train's just going to be bouncing all over the place when it's not really needed. So what can we do with LTN? Well, what LTN can do is we would have a train parked somewhere. It doesn't have to be parked at the loading spot. It can be parked anywhere. And then when one of these stops needs acid, that train will get a work order to deliver the acid. So it'll go wherever it's parked, load up on the acid, deliver it, and then go back to where it's supposed to be parked. And it's a very organic system. And this is something that'll work a lot better for low throughput things like acid. Like, if you have a really high throughput thing, like bomonium or something, you don't need to necessarily need to have something complicated like that. Like, you can just have one train. But in this situation, one train works fine because we only have one mine. But what happens if we have two mines? That means we would either need one train going to both mines, wasting time, or two trains going to this one stop, and it means one other train is going to have to be waiting for this one to move, and it means we're going to have somewhere for the trains to park, and it's more logistically complicated. So when you think about LTN and whether you should use it or not, it kind of depends on the situation and the logistics of whatever you're trying to move at that time. So in this case, this one train is fine for bomonium because we only have one mining patch right now, so that'll work for us. But for acid, it doesn't really work because we're going to have one train in at least six stops. So to prevent it from bouncing around all over the place and wasting time, we're going to use LTN for this. So that's why I'm researching it. But at the same time, we kind of need to design this train stop in a certain way, because the default behavior of LTN is that a train will park at a depot until it is needed, and then it will send it to the pickup point. But in this situation, we only have one pickup point, so it's kind of a waste of time to send the train to a depot first, and then go to the pickup point, and then go on its run. So this is going to be a kind of a special station. So let's design it. We're going to need two train stops for this. And let's just pick up some signals. I don't know how many of them we're going to need, but let's just pick them up anyway. Definitely going to want some rails, but we don't need too many. Let's just kind of pick a spot somewhere to make the design, and then we'll figure out where we want to put it later. So we have our regular train stops. I guess we need to wait for research to be done so we can do the LTN ones, but I guess we can kind of just plop them in place for now. And how it's going to work is we're actually going to put two of them right next to each other. Two separate stops. And we want to set this up to where the train can get loaded regardless of which train station it's parked at. So it's at the bottom when it gets loaded, or if it's at the top when it gets loaded. When you have inserters, that's actually pretty easy, because the train can be pretty well misaligned and these inserters will still hit the right train. But it's a little harder with fluid wings because they have to be lined up just right. So let's get it lined up for both sides, where we have the bottom one for now. Okay, so we're going to need some pumps. Now this is a pretty low throughput thing, so four pumps ought to be just fine. And we need to have some power here just to make sure that these things line up correctly. You'll know when it goes plop like that. And now let's see if the train will line up in the other location. Do we have any fuel? Doesn't look like it. Oh, there's some carbon in there. Okay, we got LTN. While I'm thinking about it, let's get these replaced. So logistics train stop is just made from a regular train stop and other components. We'll put them in there, and there you can see they have got the little combinator and the light there. So they look a little different, but get those in there. So what's this train station called? Dank Monkey. Okay. Okay. So now we're at the other stop, and you can see how the pump also lines up just because the width of the train stops just so happen to line up right here. So either will work for our purposes, so that's pretty easy. It means we only need to have one pump on one side of the tracks here, and having it on the left side probably makes sense because the train will be somewhere right in here and the processing will happen on this side. So now we want to get the rest of these pumps in here and put them in their right spots and make sure that they all work and they all connect, and they do. Everything's good there. And good train design, or good train station design, is that the buffer should be the exact same size as the train can handle. The train can handle 25K, which is the exact same as one tank. So we'll make four of those. And then just kind of put them in a way that makes sense, and this seems to line up well. And those will be the buffer tanks. So when a train comes in, it'll already have the acid ready to go, and it should fill up quite quickly. And we'll also need to get fuel to it as well, which will probably be delivered by the roadway up here. But we'll worry about that later. And that should be pretty good. Let's see. We also want to get an inserter in here and have a belt. It'll probably come from up above where the fuel is. And we'll worry about configuring LTN later. There's kind of no point to it while the train station's just in its basic mode right here, but that's all we need. So the train also is going to need to have a loop. And since it's going to be flat with this side, let's make the loop go the other way. Is that going to be enough room? Doesn't look like it. Might be easier to start the loop right there. I wonder if it's going to be possible to kind of put this down here. Not really. Probably have to make that manually. But let's have it come in right through there. Probably should have a pattern for these T's, but for now this will be just fine. When you have a complicated setup like this, it's the exit point is usually the standard signal, and the chain signals are all of the intermediate points. Okay, we have an alignment. Where do we want to put this? Probably up reasonably far here. Let's go with that. Let's pop the train bound again. Let's do it at the top station because that's going to be where it normally parks. It seems like it's just popping down to the other one. Okay, we'll have to move it manually. So it would be nice to deliver some fuel here. Let's just grab a copy of this right here. Line it up with the middle. And then come up and plop it right there. I think yellow inserters will be just fine. Okay, we need some drones in there. just the one ought to be fine. And it's leaving the fuel depot, so that process should start just fine. Let's see, this doesn't quite fit, unfortunately. Perhaps it should be on the other side. And there's... I guess it barely goes there, but it'll cover up the light, and I kind of don't like that. Even though it technically works, but... oh well. Okay, that train will receive fuel eventually. And we'll worry about the LTN and configuring that after we have all of the assets here and all of the other train stops as well. So we need to make some assets. Let's do nitric first, since that's kind of what we need the most of. Since our rubite is mining pretty slow. And that means we need to get the acid products over here. And they were kind of just randomly placed up here. Just because it was convenient, but now that we know where it needs to go, it has to be a little more thoughtfully placed. So it looks like we have some acid coming from all the way down there. So how many units is this wide? It's already getting pretty wide, but most of that's just stone, which we don't really have a choice in that matter. Okay. Well, let's use this belt. Then we're going to need to hook everything back up again. Fortunately, everything is kind of in the way, but I guess it wouldn't be. That after this is gone, it won't be in the way anymore. So, for now, this should work okay. We just need to dump everything in there. And actually get rid of this entirely. Because we're going to be delivering acid the normal way. So we don't need this anymore. Looks like there's a missing light now. So I should probably plop that there. Okay, it's only going to be one belt, but we're going to eventually have two belts here. It's just because of the position of these pipes. Really, only one belt's going to work. But it's going to be two. That's how it's going to look. Additionally, we kind of had the belts moving in random places. But now that we know where they need to go, it could perhaps be less random. And they're moving up and to the right here, but it might actually be better for them to go down. So let's get the acids where they need to go, and then we can figure out what the most efficient way to connect the rest of those belts would be. Well, I guess this is going to empty fairly quickly, so it doesn't really matter that there's only one belt. This is the stone superhighway. Actually, but putting it all the way down here probably doesn't make a lot of sense because of the position of this stuff up here. Let's see. Let's place it... let's actually do the two belts up here instead. Now that we know the position of that belt, we can kind of make this make a little more sense. Because then we can just kind of go up and join in, but it's going to be a little weird. So we'll have to do a bit of a zigzag. Might be easier just to go up there, then kind of come around here. Get it to join that way. Let's see, what about those other acids now? Well, definitely don't want to be going to the right like that. Instead, we can go straight down. Let's see, is that gonna work? It's actually gonna join right there. It's gonna be a little busy right there. That should be okay. And we can kind of combine it with this other belt too. I'm not sure how much sulfur between the two of those is produced, but it'll probably fit on a yellow belt. And then we come right down here. Get mixed in there. That might be a little busy. let's make that a red. Make this a red too, just in case. Was that it for the weird squiggly belts for acids? I think so. Fortunately, we're out of red belt. Probably should make some warehouses too while we're at it. Probably don't need a full warehouse-sized building, so a storehouse would probably be fine. So we're going to need a couple of those. One for sulfur, one for nitric, one for fluoric, and actually, we probably do want a warehouse for that salt. Because we don't have anything to do with it, so we probably want the largest possible building. I suppose another thing we can do is send it down here, actually. Which is our repository of things we cannot use. Although we can use some of that that mineralized oil there. So we probably need to create a line to send that back. But we can kind of wait since we're not really going to use very much of it right now. So there's probably no point in setting up the line quite yet. But actually, it probably makes sense just to send the salt here. Because we can't put it anywhere else. And having a large repository of warehouses means that we won't run into the problem of the one warehouse, salt warehouse, getting filled up. It's going to have to fill up the shared space. So having those three will probably be okay. Man, how's the base going on everything else? Looks like it's short on iron. And it kind of took care of copper, but it's also kind of filling up again. Promise is just all of this nickel. Trying to get rid of it, but maybe that process should stop now. We might have enough space in the system to get the rest of the manufacturing set up. But yeah, that's a lot of Invar. Let's close that off and let it fill up. Although it's actually going to take a long time to fill up everything, so I don't know about that. Maybe just disconnect that instead. Because I think the production of all of that extra nickel was making batteries, because batteries use a lot of lead, which was creating a ton of nickel as a byproduct. So maybe if we're not making batteries anymore, that quite won't be such a huge problem. And then we'll have iron again, and then it'll start working through all of this copper. Okay, acid continues. Then we'll need to do some processing. Probably want to leave some space for pipes in here. Because the pipes are going to have to kind of come in there, or the other way really, but... So we do want to leave some space, so we don't want to squish it in too hard here. Let's say... leave that space there. So we need a storehouse. Let's say, anywhere's fine. Boom. And I think, we're only going to be producing 7.5 of this a second, so we only need a yellow belt. And there's a couple ways to do this, but actually doing the strongbox filter ought to be just fine. Fortunately, it's a little too close to the train tracks, if these tracks keep continuing, that this won't work. At least not very cleanly. But we'll have two belts going into it. We don't want this holding a bunch of stuff, so let's just kind of limit it there a bit. Let's see, the output will probably have to be up here. Because it's going to kind of swing around. Just because it's a little too close. Didn't really think of that. I guess I could move it. But we'll have a loader here. And we do have 5 filter slots. So as long as we're dealing with less than 5 things, we can use loaders to filter for us. So where is nitric going to be? There we go. Sodium nitrate. So it'll send out the sodium nitrate there. And then these other ones will do the sulfur, the fluorite, and the salt, wherever that is. There we go. So that'll go down, although it looks like its alignment is a little wrong. And yeah, it's a little... zigzaggy. If we move this up by two spaces, it would work better. Is it going to get blocked by anything if we move it up by two spaces? No, doesn't look like it. Let's just move the belts. Okay, let's hook this up. And then it sends the salt through because that's not being pulled off here. It's probably just going to fill up. So temporarily I'll unlock this just to allow the whole system to fill in here so we can actually get the acids we need to process. So there's the fluorite. Okay, there's some sodium nitrate. And that gets pulled through. It is filling up in this chest, but just because we're not unloading it as fast as we're putting it in there. But now it's going to load in here. I guess we need some lights. Okay, we need to do our sodium nitrate processing. So two air filters into two chemical plants with two more chemical plants, and then three as an output. Although that's pretty close to two. Maybe I should just use two because it's an easy number. And then we'll need to have 90 purified water. I think this the way the setup was created was to pull off purified water from a central source. But since we're not doing it like that, we probably need our own water purifiers for all of this. So, how many water purifiers is that? It's probably not going to let me do it easily. Let's see here. Because this is set by input, it's not going to let me do it. Well, okay then. Looks like we've already got some other output set. So how much for 90? A fraction of one. So we have nitric gases from sodium nitrate and compressed air. We need to have two of those. Powered by two air filters. So we can kind of plop them in there. Use our plastic pipes because we have a bunch of them. Need some undergrounds though. I think there's still some in here. Oh yes. Quite a few. Although we do need to get the acids in here as well. And I have too much stuff in my inventory. Sending the gases in, and then there would be a belt coming in. Something like that. It's not necessarily lined up with that, but that's kind of the idea. Set this to inserters. We need some red ones. Then we create our two gases. You gotta squint at them, because they're kind of hard to tell the difference, but they are different. That one's got the one red line, this one has two, and it's also got the molecule with two circles, that one's got three. So they are slightly different. Actually, having some buffer tanks in here might work out fairly well since we have two different machines now. Let's see, well first we have our byproducts that we have to take care of, which is the nitrogen monoxide. Which one is that? The one with the one red line, which I suppose makes sense. So we'll put that right there. It doesn't need to have a top-up valve. We just want all of it. Then that output comes through. And then we need two machines adding oxygen to make nitrogen dioxide gas. And will this line up like this? Let's see. Nope. Because of course not. They never do. Let's just place them over here and then figure out what's going to work best. So let's make those two high. Those will be one. Let's see, oxygen. Yeah, something like this. There we go. And that's going to handle all of the byproduct gas. Because what we want is the dioxide gas. Which we can pass through here. Let's see. And we need another tank. Guess we can try to keep it in line with that to make it look as pretty as possible. Although, let's add a space in there just to make it look slightly more symmetrical. And then put a space here because we need to leave room in this output for the monoxide gas to become dioxide gas. So this is a great application of the top-up valve. Okay, so now we'll have dioxide gas, which we just need to add to purified water to get acid. We need 2.1 or 3 plants if we want to be 100% here. And actually, it might work fine, since these are spaced up a little bit, so it might look alright to have 3 plants going down. I like how I'm thinking of how it's going to look on whether or not it gets 2 or 3 chemical plants, not what the ratio says it should be. But 0.1 is not that big a deal, so I'm not too worried about 0.1. But let's see here. Which one is the acid? There we go. So make that to 2 space and that the 1. This is probably a good place to plop the water treatment plant. Nice little open square. But that creates our output of acid. So now the question is, should there be a storage tank right here? Or a storage tank at the station? I'll make a second tank right here. Seems a little weird to be controlling the output of this based on what the station is doing as opposed to the rest of the factory, because other factory components might pull acid here that don't use the train. So it might make more sense to have another tank right here. So do we need one or do we have one in storage? Oh, we've got some in storage. And I guess let's just put it up here since it's in line. And does anything actually make nitric acid besides the recipe to make nitric acid? You wouldn't think so. Yeah, it's just a product here, so nothing else will come into this, so we can just let this fill up to 100%. And the trees are kind of in the way. Well, I guess I could... the robots are right there. While they're sitting around doing nothing, I suppose. Can sick them on some of these trees. Just mark all of this stuff. Okay, and then it can just kind of place right here in the middle. Fortunately, it won't quite work like that because of that position of the underground. So it looks like it's going to have to be one square to the left here. And that'll go up there and have to send water up to the pipe bus up there. I think this is pretty good now. So we could probably just figure out the exact spot we want it to go, which is probably not very far from where it is here. Yeah, something like right there. I think everything got placed. Wait, how did I get stuck? I like walked in here and now I can't get out. That doesn't make much sense. That was weird. I wonder if there's something special about plastic pipes that allows that kind of behavior. Anyway, we have sodium nitrate output right there, which is pretty good. And looks like the acid's all emptied out there, which is good. Because now we can kind of come up here and remove that. Just connect this the normal way. So we need to get oxygen in here. And we need to get the saline water out. Let's see, where does saline water line up? Right there. So let's get oxygen lined up the same way. And that's not a good alignment. And then saline water, which is right here. Okay, oxygen's in there. Now we just need to get the purified water. And we're going to need purified water for a couple of different things here. Basically, all of the acids have to have water added. The minor acids, we don't need much. However, the sulfuric acid, we need quite a bit. So let's have one pipe for the non-sulfuric acid ones, and then a separate pipe for sulfuric acid. Uh-oh, out of fuel. Well, it can run on battery power, technically, because it has some solar panels. But fuel is better. So we need to send a water pipe through. Let's see. Probably will line up just fine somewhere around here. It's already got power, so we're good there. And we'll just run it at max distance. And this might compete with space for other acid processing, but we'll move things around as necessary for that. So there we go. Now it's producing the purified water. And that the system should be good to go now. Those inserters don't seem to be fast enough. Looking good. Pumping out a bunch of nitric acid. We have a lot of acid to work with, but it's going down pretty fast. Okay. Well, now we need to set up the signal from this warehouse all the way down to the thing that produces the nitric acid, which is the rubite chunk refining. Because if we're full up on sodium nitrate, there's no point in these things running and producing more because they share a belt with other acid products, and we definitely don't want that belt to get clogged up. So we'll just send a signal down here to all of those inserters and tell them to turn off if this warehouse gets too full. And it holds 256 items. And I think they're in a stack of 200. So, let's say if it's at 50,000. It's nice having the train tracks have their power lines, because then moving around the base can be fairly simple when you've got signal wires to run through them. This is going to be a little zigzaggy wire, because we have to go there, down here, and then back up again. Okay, we should have our sodium nitrate signal, which we do, and it's running down quickly. So sodium nitrate has to be under 50,000 for this inserter to be on. And that applies to all of these. Although, I think they need to be near and far. So let's make this the near one. So that will be near, and that will be near. Okay. Well, sodium nitrate's gone. It all got processed. We've got nothing in there, nothing in there, and it's all made it. Well, I guess it basically filled up the tank. So now we need to get it to the train station. And let's just make this top tank the sodium nitrate tank. So that'll be 1, 2, 3, and 4. It's important to figure out where all these acids are, because when this train delivers, since it's going to be carrying all four acids at any given time, it means that the station it parks at to deliver nitric acid, the actual pump and tank at its station needs to be off of the fourth car, not off of any of the other cars. So it's important to remember how that's set up. Let's see, this tank is a little dark. Put one more light here. But there we go. It's going into the tank, and then going into the train. It would be kind of nice to quickly get that acid over here, but I guess it's holding out, so it's not critical. We're not doing much with it right now besides some slow research. Speaking of slow research, How are we doing? Okay. Copper's getting worked down a little bit. We are increasing in nickel, but it's not anything crazy. And that's the end of this episode. On the next one, we are going to build the other three acids that we need for our base. Thanks for watching. I'll see you later.